हेलो, मैं आपसे कुछ खास बात बताना चाहती हूँ, मगर आप सबको मेरी भाषा मालूम नहीं है। अनलेस यू नो हिंदी, यू वुडंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई जस्ट सेड। व्हाट आई सेड वाज आई वांटेड टू टेल यू समथिंग वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट। अनलेस यू नो माय लैंग्वेज, यू कैंट अंडरस्टैंड इट। ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट नो एंड मस्ट हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड LLMs इन द रीसेंट टाइम्स। लार्ज लैंग्वेज मॉडल्स आर वेरी पॉपुलरली नोन फॉर जनरेटिंग टेक्स्ट, but it is also important to know that LLMs can also do a very good job of translating languages. Why is this important? It seems only about 25% of the internet users, their primary language is English. And more than 65% of the users on the internet prefer to be provided information in their primary languages, respective primary languages. Also, more than 70% of the internet users would like to receive support, issue resolution, etc., in their preferred languages. Now, because they do not receive the help in their primary languages, more than 65% of these internet users are using machine translations to get the help that they need. So it seems that machine translations are essential for us to do business. So I'm going to explain machine translations in two parts. First, I will talk about how we have been doing to machine translation so far, and then I will jump to the advantage of the large language models and how we are going to do translations from now. So let's see how machine translations are done. Machine translations use artificial intelligence to translate between languages automatically without any human help. So how do they do that? Let's take an example here. English, Spanish, and Japanese. To translate between any of these languages, you need linguistic rules and you need dictionaries for each of these languages. And the machine translations are done in multiple approaches. The rule-based approach. The rule-based approach is the one that predominantly uses the linguistic rules and the dictionaries, and also the parallel dictionaries that have the meanings of two different languages, the source language as well as the target language. And then we have the second approach called the statistical approach. It takes a totally different approach of leveraging the human translations and learning the patterns from them and making very smart guesses of those translations and delivering those translations. Both approaches work very, very well, by the way. We take it one notch up with the neural approach, where, as in rule-based and statistical, it actually is looking at each word to get to the translations. Neural takes it one notch up because it is actually looking at the sentence constructions to do the translations. Now, as in any other approach, you can take a combination of these approaches and make it a hybrid approach. So, as we discussed, the traditional way makes use of the linguistic rules as well as the dictionaries, right? And it goes through the supervised learning and so on. Large language models do the translations differently, right? They make use of the content that is already available in different languages. We call it the large corpuses of parallel text. That is, the examples of the same text in different languages like English, Spanish, Japanese, and so on, and we feed it to the models. So the large language models, as you all know, use the transformer models, and they have both the encoder and decoder capabilities. On top of that, the large language models typically make use of two approaches in doing the translations. Number one is the sequence-to-sequence approach. In the sequence-to-sequence approach, you can take an input text and feed it to the encoder, right? Hello, how are you? And the encoder goes through the text and creates the semantic representation of that text and also captures the meaning of the text and passes it on to the decoder. Now, the decoder is capturing the semantic representation and the meaning and translating it to the representative target language. You say, hello, how are you in English? And if your target language is going to be Spanish, you will get hola como estas. The second approach, also interesting, is the attention model. The attention model is a little bit of a lazy model compared to the sequence to sequence one. Attention model is focusing on the main relevant vocabulary of the sentence. It is not going through the entire sentence. So for example, it can pick up hello and how are you and focus on the hola and como estas, but it is still going to capture the meaning and the semantic representation essence through the encoder and decoder. As you can see, the large language models, instead of using the linguistic rules and the dictionaries, are really focusing on capturing the patterns and the relationships between the data and translating it. It's quite obvious now that everybody wants to be communicated in their own language, including our customers. Let's go leverage large language models to meet them at the table and communicate in their own language. Thank you for watching. Before you leave, please click subscribe and like.